What's my viewers at? So I'm at just under 500, oh, just over 500. Nice. I've nearly hit like 50,000 views on my channel. Sick. Don't forget, guys, you can always subscribe, follow, like, donate, whatever you want. Or, of course, just stay here and watch, and that is absolutely freaking good enough for me, man. Enjoy the StarCraft games with myself. But here we are, guys, jumping into the last series. Someone will be eliminated from the Red Bull Online Qualifier number 2, spawning down at the bottom left. Swapping over the scoreboard so it matches. We have playing for Team Axiom. He is going to be the blue Protoss player. Crank is opponent. Someone we should know a little bit better. We did get to cast him in our own private tournament just a day ago. It is going to be Armani representing Team Samson Galaxy. Khan. Get Samson Galaxy Khan. But yeah, he has a very funky style. He's, you know, obviously very good. He did 2-0 Oz, I believe, in my own tournament. So he's definitely good. And we do have a scout come in just to make sure that no shenanigans come his way. And he is, you know, he's going to know it's force cross position. So he's coming down here. Going to see what's happening. The gateway first. Could be interesting. Then just type to you guys in chat so you know that the game has started. Just so you know. Okay, so the natural will get taken quite soon. Hatchery first. Lots of hatchery first. Was it the wrong map? I don't think it was the wrong map. It may have been. It just looked like he dropped instantly from the game. But yeah, everything's, you know, like, I don't mind talking to the stream chat for the first 2 minutes. There's not much to do. We can see the build order up here. It's a gateway first into what should be a Nexus. There's the Cybercore. Want pizza again? Yeah, I want some pizza. I wouldn't mind some pizza. We'll see, though. Like, I probably, like, by the time I finish this, we'll, let's see if the shop is still open for pizza. If not, you know, ham and cheese toasties are delicious. I want to make my own pizza soon. Like, making your own pizza must just be delicious. And a 3-hash before pull, I absolutely love it. Love it, man. I love the greediest builds, because you normally, like, you kind of skip the early game and you jump straight into the mid game, where, like, you have your tech and all that, and your economy is saturated, and then you build units, and there's just, like, lots of power in, man. I love it. And then you just, like, get lots of trades normally in the mid game. But yeah, 3-hatch before pool. Very risky. Zealot did get produced. He's gonna come up here and, oh, he hasn't seen it yet. So he sees the pool in production. He's like, wait, what? Gonna come down here and he's gonna know what is happening. Do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do. And he's like, okay, that's what you're going for. The cleaning bot. God, you must have a hard job sometimes. Like, I wonder if it goes around, like, cleaning up all the blood. But, okay, so there's the next gateway. Number 2. The pylon can be added on in a nice position. Not too, too far away. But we will need to see a third. Is it going by there? Is it going by here? Is it going in the wall? Where are you going? You can't be just doing a 2-gate. Warp gate is, like, he should go for it right now if he wants a good timing. The proxy pylon, I think he'll add one on by here, but... Okay, there it is. Gates 3 and 4. And a nice wall off. They have been spotted by this overlord, so Armani has been clued in on this. And don't tell me he misses that. He should get it on the way down. And there he will find it. Great little snipe there. That's a massively important snipe here for Armani. The pylon does finish up. He's not going to be able to defend it, but Spine has now started. So he's going to have some sort of, you know, static defense, something to defend. Another pylon getting closer. The warp gate is getting closer to finishing up. Zerglings are in production. No Zerglin speed is going to make this very hard. And three queens actually will add in a little bit of extra DPS. I would like to see a second Spine. A second Spine just to guarantee it. Because if he holds this, he's in, you know, a fairly good position. You can just build non-stop drones. He runs forward, trying to get some of the Zealots with the Zerglings, trying to stop maybe the high numbers being warped in here, and he will get some of them, but he took a lot of losses. 7-for-1 is not a good trade. He got the probe. The Spinecrawler is here, so the hatchery is going to have a hard time to get targeted down by Zealots. He's going to move it slightly closer. And the queens will come with this. Transfuses are more than available to keep the spine crawl alive. Five queens are here. No recall is available. He used it on a time warp. This is a big deal, guys. In the meantime, we have the sentry. I think he might have pressed F2 there by accident. Who knows? The stalkers just trying to deal that extra damage. Transfuse keeps it alive. Queens have range 5. Stalkers have range 6. The gas has been taken. The circling speed now starting. He has 110 seconds, but by then there will be enough energy for the photo, for the recall. So if, you know, a lot of Zerglings stream out around them, he should just recall. But this is actually getting quite scary. He's up to 10 Zealots. Armani's not going to know that this is coming. I would like to see maybe a unit run all the way around. No, he can't. This is... Oh no, he can go this way, my bad. Ooh, Stalker took a little too much damage. What the hell is Rabbit? What? Okay. And yeah, this is really weird. He's kind of like, he's building probes and stuff behind this. So he's, oh my god, that's 19 Zealots. They're running up. If they don't get the surface area though to connect onto everything that they need, they're not going to be very useful. Same applies to the Zealots, the Zerglings. Oh my god, the 8 queens in the back dealing so much extra damage available with the transfuses. The Spinecrawler is still alive on top of this. It only has 2 kills, but it will now fall. We still have 8 queens, the Zerglings. Oh my god, there's no time warp available. The units are going to get chased down in a second. As the Zergling speed does finish up, the queens will come off creep. And with that, the Mothership Core will be safe. Or should be safe. Nice micro coming out of Crank to make sure he doesn't lose absolutely everything. Or, you know, like, they're forced into a choke right now, but yeah. Armani's going up to his lair. He's starting to build his workers. The queens are coming with this. He didn't spew any creep out there, even though he has this many queens, but okay. And this should start to get cleaned up really soon. The Mothership Core has to be so careful. Robo and a double gas added on. We only have 3 gas. This one has not been taken. The pylon will get killed off, and with that, the units will be trapped here. Unless he waits until he gets 100 energy and recalls. Okay, the delay could be longer than 2 minutes, but it's probably to do with the fact that there's always the inbuilt delay, which is always about 30 seconds or so longer. Yeah, it's just about 2.5 to 3 minutes, but we have a hallucinated oracle flying towards that natural. It's 35v41 workers, so Armani does have to start getting on top of that. He hasn't had his injects, and the Hydro Den does get spotted. This Overlord Overseer comes down here, sees what's going on. And, yeah, so it's going to see that there's a lot of sentries, which, if it goes for Hydro Den, it actually could hurt him. Your sentries do not do well against Hydras. Your force fields do not do well against Hydras. They, you know, just shoot over them, like it doesn't benefit them. But this is going to be a two-based all-in. Yeah, this is actually a completely full two-based all-in. 3 gas geysers, immortals off 6 gateways. There's the second immortal, the War Prism coming in. I don't think he saw the rocks get destroyed there. And he has to be careful because if these... Oh, okay. Actually, it's probably better to go for this because you can wall off with one unit. These rocks have slightly been destroyed. These are not in view. Oh my god, these are not in view. Oh. Oh. No, never mind. Could have done that. I would, like, leave a few back there, man. That'd be sick. Okay, he's not going for a third with this, so this is a very heavy all-in. The sentries are getting warped in, so he could maybe go for them. He wants to... Oh! He's got to be so careful. This many Zerglings are not going to be a challenge for these many units. This is the rest of the units that Crank did keep alive, and he has to be so careful. Force field lock these... You know, like, force field there, you know, locks them in. That is nearly it. Another spine getting added into the mix. The Hydras are out! Wow, it's actually Hydra. It's not Hydra Roads, it's just Hydra. But there are 15 Zealots, 2 Immortals, 9 Sentries. Here's a big counterattack of Zerglings. I think it's for a flank, though. You want to get a flank against the Sentries. Is he going for it? Okay, I think he's going for it. The flank is coming. The pylon is going to be able to see this, but the Zerglings are going to close the distance and surround all the units. The force fields are getting dropped. The Immortals are targeting down the Queens, which do not receive this benefit of the damage from that armored Immortal. And it looks like as the sentries are dwindling down, the Immortal is hallucinating. The Hydras are still alive. It looks like GG will be called in just a moment's time as Amani does clean this up, but we could have a stage 2 Immortal all in. But no, Crank is just going to GG, and Amani will move on.